All right, let's get back into the word of faith on tonight. I shared something and I saw some people, and I want to encourage men and women. It's been in my heart and my spirit to go ahead and encourage all of us that consecration is coming up, and I want all of us to begin to pray. And I know there are very faithful people in here, so I don't have to just remind you, and especially those that might be watching online. I heard this today now. Prayer is going to be from 12 noon and 7 p.m. during our consecration. And I'm praying and asking many of you all, whether you be in either service, but one of those services throughout the 21 days of consecration, try your best to make it to every service. Now, my word is always, if there's a purpose of heart, God gonna make a way for you to be here. If you got a purpose of heart, if you want to be in the house of the Lord. So those that are watching as well, 21 days of our consecration, you got time now to be praying about it and making sure if that's a desire. Some people do have a desire to be in the house of the Lord, and I know many of you all do. So I'm praying that is almost like Paul said in Romans 12, I'm begging you by really the mercy of God that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice. And so it's so important. If it's a purpose of heart, because many of you all, I see you, I know you're going to be here. It's a part of your life. It's a part of who you are when it comes down to the things of God. But those that maybe don't attend Bible study regularly on a Wednesday night, please just pray and ask God just to make a way for you possibly to be in those prayers, those 21 days, because it's very, very important that we do be in prayer. New Year's Eve seed. Everybody ready for your New Year's seed? Give God a praise for New Year's seeds. Come on, give God a praise for New Year's seed. All right. I have not really mentioned so much about it, not saying I'm stressing it, because that's not something that is forced to do. It's always a purpose of your heart as well. But your New Year's offering seed, $230. Those that so desire to sow the $230, sow your $230. If you desire to sow beyond that, and whatever you have, if it's $23, if it's $2.30, whatever it might be, but you want to sow that seed unto the Lord, because I do believe, I don't know about many of you all, not because I'm a pastor and all of this here, but I'm telling you, God has watched over my seed from the beginnings of years to the ends of years. And I give him praise for my seed. And do I got any testimonies in here, some witnesses in here, that God will really watch over your seed? If you honor God with your seed, he'll do it. So tonight, I'll probably be touching in that area just a little bit, not much, because I was going to talk about it on Sunday, but I'm really heavily into right now, 1 Samuel chapter 2. 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse number 3. I'm not going to be there long. It's so much I want to give you in this here, because it's going to help some people, because this is some things that the Lord is really showing me and saying to me right now. 1 Samuel 2 and 3, very, very important now. Talk no more so very proudly. Let no arrogance come from your mouth, for the Lord is the God of knowledge. And I want you just that area there, I want you to keep it. For the Lord is the God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed. I was sharing this with my son a moment ago, and this is very, very important. I want you to get this here. To know something or have the knowledge of something and don't act is not faith. To know something or have the knowledge of something, especially, and don't act, you know, it's not faith. Because when you hear something, you have to act on it. So when I look at this, for the Lord is the God of knowledge, that's understanding, clarity. We all have some type of understanding of something. And if we have some understanding of something and do not act on it, it's not faith. To hear the teaching of tithing or to hear the teaching of sowing and do not act on it. And that's what it's all about. Everything that you hear, faith comes by hearing. Hearing comes by the word of God. It's all about acting. It's all about acting. And that's so, so important to believers to get this in your spirit. Now, James chapter 2 and verse number 21 and all of verse number 21 through 26 in the Message Bible. I gave this Sunday, so this is just a recap. And especially, I said, Lord, you know, he gave me this on Sunday a little bit, and it's challenging for me to title it, but it's for someone. Lord, help me to walk by faith. And now some of us got it, but I'm so thankful for some people who really responded to that through social media that I saw this week. And they typed it out, Lord, help me to walk by faith. And I want you to get this here now, because I know some people say I'm walking by faith, but faith is not just believing in something. Faith is acting. It's acting. So everybody get this now, because it's very, very important, because a lot of people hear faith, but they do not act. They do not act. And that's why James was saying, some say they have faith, but they have no works. Works there again is translated to the word action. You got to always act. Wasn't our ancestor Abraham made right with God by works when he placed his son Isaac on the sacrificial altar? Isn't it obvious that faith and works are yoke partners, that faith expresses itself in works? Listen, that the works are works of, let's keep going, faith of faith, the full meaning of belief in the scripture sentence. This Abraham believed God and was set right with God includes his action. Now, I want us to get this to me because this is very, very important. I want people to always understand this here. Faith is, again, it's acting now. It's acting. I want us to really get that. Very, very important, including his action. It's that mess of believing and acting that God Abraham, that got Abraham named God's friend. Is it not evident that a person is made right with God, not by a barren faith, but by faith fruitful in works? Now that's very, very important. Can I go through the rest of that there, if it's any way possible? Can I go through the rest of that there? Thank you. Okay, the same with Rahab, that Jericho harlot wasn't her action in hiding God's spies and helping them escape that seamless unite us believing and doing what counted with God. The very moment you separate body and spirit, you end up with a corpse. Separate faith and works and you get the same thing, a corpse. And then if you look at that in the King James Version, just put that verse in the King James Version, verse number 26, if you could. Just put it in the King James Version, if it's way possible that you can do that for me. Because it's very, very important. I want every believer to get this here. For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. That's action. And I want you, everybody, to get this here now. Because when you're teaching of faith, faith is, again, it's acting. I'm acting. Some people don't have a problem with acting when they go to the mall. With their money. I want to get that. Some people don't have a problem. You can see something on the shelf, wherever, and nothing tells you not to get that particular shoe or that dress or that boot. You don't even need faith for that. You just know I need money. Come on, Zion. Am I right? But when it comes down to the kingdom of God and having to put your action in with your faith, that's when the enemy tried to tell you, oh, you can't do this here. You can't sow that seed. You can't give that tithe. You can't give that offering. You got to think about, you got a light bill. You got to think about, you got, you know, your water, your all of these things. But outside of the kingdom, you don't even need faith for certain things outside the kingdom. You just do it. You know, seriously, I know I have to test for myself too in this area here. There are times when I know the blessing of God that's on my life at a time, and the enemy will tell me sometimes, say, you can't get that there. And then I have to think about it and say, why can't I? Because if I go to Nemo's, I'm going to do it. Y'all ain't got to say amen. And it ain't going to take no faith for me to buy what I want to get. But when it's time for me to come to the kingdom of God and write that check out for this particular seed that I can't see, nothing tangible that I'm going to get back. But because of my faith says, you know, I trust God. I trust God with my tithes. I trust God with my offerings. And even though I can't see it, because if I'm going to live out of Luke 6 and 38, and if Luke 6 and 38 tells me to give, and it's going to be given back to me, good measures pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall be given into my bosom, or men will give into my bosom. I got to trust what the word says. Go back to that 1 Samuel chapter 2 again, because that's, I want you to get this here in that verse number 3. 1 Samuel 2 and 3. Very, very important that we get something that the latter part. For the Lord is the God of knowledge. If I got knowledge, if I got information on something, I got to act on it. I got to act on it. For the Lord is the God of knowledge, and by his actions are weighted. You and I have to act. We have to act on what we believe. And that's where it go again. I'm acting on what the word says. I'm acting on what the word says. And that's why this word has been in my spirit so strongly, especially when it comes down, the seed of faith, the word, the seed of faith. Luke 8 and verse number 11. Thank Deacon Brown so much. He helped me out on this past Sunday. But watch this again. Now the parable is this. Listen, this is so important to me. This is really so important to me. And the Lord just told me to write this. It's simple. I've grown by the word. I've grown by the word. I really have. I've grown by the word. Not by how I shout, not just by how I give, not just how much. No, I've grown by the word of God. I've grown by the word of God. I've grown by the word of God. Now, the parable is this. The seed is what? The word of God. The seed is the word of God. The seed is the word of God. The seed is the word of God. That's what it is, the seed. And all the seed does, once it is planted, and if it gets on the heart, it causes you to grow. Yes. Your whole life changes. Yes. Your whole life changes. Because now you're walking by the word of God. You're walking by God. In the beginning was what? The word. And the word was what? With God. And the word was what? Was God. It was God, the word. I'm walking by the word. I'm walking by the word. Let me see if I can get some things out what the Lord want me to give to you on the night again. Okay, watch this here. And this is very, very important now. And I want you to write this down. I don't know who this is for. Every seed sower is a prosperous citizen of the kingdom of God. Every seed sower is a prosperous citizen of the kingdom of God. A seed sower, you have to prosper when you sow into God's kingdom. You have to prosper. It's a principle. Once you put that faith into action, once you start acting on this thing, and once you start becoming a kingdom citizen of the kingdom of God, every seed sower is a prosperous citizen of the kingdom of God. As you sow into God's kingdom, as you start seeing God giving you favor with not just only him, but with man, you start seeing all that word coming alive. You start seeing it. And that's why you have to. And that's why I have to continually just sow into the kingdom of God. Now get this here because it's very, very important now. Very, very important. And I said this on Sunday, but you got to hear this again before I go further. Give with a future of being a blessing. Every believer in here, you begin to give. Give with a future. You that are watching, give with a future of being a blessing. And it has to start there. Do not give for now. Do not give or do not withhold your giving thinking that I got to hold on to this. I was taught like this, hold on to this for a rainy day. That's the way I was taught. I used to hear that so much. You better hold on to something. You know, people used to tell me like this, and family used to tell me that you ain't gonna never have nothing because you give everything away. But then I took on the spirit. I took on the spirit that I wanted to give, not knowing here in 2022, God was going to tell me that I had to give with in mind of a future of being a blessing. I had to have a mindset that I wanted to be a blessing. And where did all that come from? Genesis chapter 12. That's where it came from with me. And I'm on this thing right now with this being passionate about faith because I'm very passionate about faith. I'm very passionate about faith. There are some people really, within the next 3, 4, 5 years, you probably will not even be working on a job. Now, I'm going to speak this over somebody. This is the truth. And this happened in my life. I sold my way off of a job. I did. I sold my way off of a job. I knew I did. When I didn't even know it, I sold my way off of a job. June 2023 would be 25 years I've been doing this full time. 25 years I've been doing this full time. Have not had to run over the country, have not had to do certain things, play no gimmick, play no games, twisting people's hand. Come on, somebody. Be a blessing to me. Come on, using some type of gimmick. Y'all ain't got to say amen. Putting on certain programs to raise money. You don't have to do that. Because I was giving with a future in mind of being a blessing. I wish you could just, I know, now watch this here now. Having a lot of faith notes, what I said to you on Sunday, and not acting on it, it's no good to you. It's like James says, like you just be holding yourself or your face in a mirror. Because, yes, I can give you information. And watch this here again. Going back to that 1 Samuel 2 and 3 now. Going back to 1 Samuel 2 and 3. Put it up there real quick. Because for the Lord is the God of what? Knowledge. Information. And he the God now. But it say the Lord is the God of knowledge and by his action. My God, I want somebody to get something in your spirit. When I know it, I got to do something. All I need to do is get exposed to the word of faith. When I got exposed to the word of faith, it started changing things. I start acting. I start acting on what I believe. I start trusting God. I heard someone told me don't be an inconsistent tither. I heard someone told me to be a consistent tither. When I heard that I had got the information, I got the knowledge of it. I began to work the principles of it. I began to see God rebuking the devourer for my sake. Oh, I wish I had 20 people could grab hold of something right now. And I was giving with the right motive. Yeah. I was learning how to support those. I was learning how to get behind someone else's vision. Yeah. I grabbed hold of Luke 16 and 12 so strongly until people used to tell me all the time, they're using you, they're taking advantage of you. I didn't even know all of this at the time. And if you have not been faithful in that which is another, who will give you what is your own? And some people wanting God to do something so bad for them, but they don't know how to get behind somebody else's vision and push that vision. And I live this out. And when it's time for your vision. See, I had a, Bishop Wiley Jackson, I could use him because he did it. He said, bury your vision. I had a vision. He said, bury your vision and support my vision. And when it's time for your vision, it's going to have a resurrection Sunday. And his words that he spoke to me came to pass in my life. His words he spoke to me came to pass in my life. I'm serious. And I was mature enough to do everything I could to push his vision. If we did a crusade special, we did a crusade in Brunswick one time for 3 days with him. And we didn't have no social media. I had to write flyers out. And I was passing flyers out all over town, putting them on posters. Oh, y'all got to see me. I was doing all that. That was my action. Not even knowing that, but I was pushing another man's vision. And I was just putting flyers out everywhere. People used to tell me all the time, man, they're using him. They're taking advantage of him. They're just using him. New people getting big off of him. They're doing this here, not knowing all of this was going to come to pass in my life. Because I had some knowledge of it. It didn't take me long to say, if you have not been faithful in what is another man, who will give you what is your own? It didn't take long. That's why I said, and I thank God for Elder Patrick again, when he brought this back up to me a few days ago. And I want you to get this here because this is what the Lord gave me. And so I hear it coming back to my spirit right now. When God needs you to use your faith, he does not have time convincing you. I want you to get this. I'm very serious. When God needs you to use your faith, he do not have time trying to convince you. Rhonda, I promise you I'm going to do this here for you. You do this here. But God, okay, I got to find Angela. I need you to do this here. But God, Michonne, I need you to do this here for me. Okay? So Transvan, I need you to do this here for me. Okay, God, whatever you want me to do. Don't have the resources, don't have the means. But whatever you tell me to do. When he told me to believe for these 21 acres of land, it didn't hit me until I was in Chicago, Illinois. After I got through preaching one night, went back to my hotel room. When he gave me the word, I called others to do what I called you to do. He said, they just didn't believe me. He said, you was not my first choice. That stays with me. That stays with me. I could see myself sitting on the side of the bed that night, just finishing preaching for Bishop Larry Trotter, the anointing, the power of God was so strong in Chicago, having an amazing time, two services that I just preached to, and going back to my room in a nice hotel room there, and everything is right, got me a butler, he's bringing me some food to my room, and an old Georgia boy from the country, he in the city of Chicago, big balling, whatever you want to call it, shot calling, whatever they want to call it. That's an old street term. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm still. Oh, my God. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. And as soon as I get in my room and I sit on the side of my bed, and you know I'm about to take my shoes off and everything, and I hear the Holy Ghost say, I call others to do what I call you to do. He said, they just didn't believe me. And you was not my first choice. Seemed like my whole head was like a balloon. Seemed like a pin went, because he was telling me, you was not the first to believe for these 21 acres of land. But you had enough crazy faith with no money to get some believers who had faith like you to go sling oil when they told y'all was crazy, when they said whoever had 21 acres of land in Brunswick. But we kept walking out here on Sunday nights with our headlights on our cars because we had no light. And we kept slinging oil. And we kept saying that it's our. We're going to possess the land. And people were talking about, I ain't never heard nothing about no possessing no land. Well, you ain't never heard from the children of Israel. You never heard what God told Moses. I need you to go get 12 spies. And I need you to take them in there and spy the land and see whether it's good or whether it's bad. See whether it is plenty. 10 came back with a negative report and say we can't do it because we see giants in the land. They told me we didn't have the money to get the land, but I still had some crazy people that say that, Pastor, we well able. Let's go ahead and do what the scripture says. Every plate that the soles of your feet tread on, I'm going to give it to you. I need some people that will act on the word of God and not on their situation. Push your neighbor and say, God wants to do something with your faith. You got to hear the people used to tell me, say, you're crazy. You're crazy. Ain't nobody never got no 21 acres of land. I'm going to give the testimony because the testimony got to help somebody. Hallelujah. Thank God for all of the others in the Bible that I can preach and talk about. But there need to be some examples in the earth so you can grab hold of their faith. Y'all ain't got to say, hey, man, I wish I had 20 people up here. Why you think we need Hebrews chapter 6 and verse number 12? Put it up there. Why you think we need this? This is very, very important that you do not become sluggish, but you imitate those who through their faith and patience inherit the promises. That you imitate them. Hallelujah. Don't be upset. Don't be mad. Don't get with everybody else who talk about them. Oh my God. Don't get with everybody else. Oh, that's all they about. And you still struggling and you still robbing Peter to pay Paul. And I need somebody to point me to something where God have already said that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof and they that dwell in it. I need somebody to point me to what the word of God said. Hallelujah. His blessing will overtake me. They'll run me down. I need 20 people to give God a praise because 2023, it's going to be an amazing year for you. Somebody shout right now. And the Lord just told me to tell you, whatever you in faith for, it ain't going to take long for it to come to pass. I need 30 people to give God a praise like, it ain't going to take long for this thing to come to pass. Guess what? It ain't going to take 30 years for me to pay that house off. Guess what? It ain't going to take 4 years for me to pay that car off. Guess what? It ain't going to take all that time for me to pay. Come on. Because I'm going to walk by faith and not by sight. I'm going to walk by the word of God. So if he said that he'll blot it out, he's going to blot it out. I got so much crazy faith right now, I want to go and buy up all the loan companies, what them things was when I had to go pay my bills to collection agents. I see two of them empty. And I can remember the days I had to go in there. Y'all ain't got to say amen. I said, can you give me the faith, God? Can you give me the resources that I can go buy them two buildings that I used to have to go and pay my collection agent? Can you give me that building that when I walked in that door that day, that woman told me, this bill is paid, when I knew that bill was not paid. When I walked to that counter and pay my monthly payment, and that woman say, that's paid. I said, no, ma'am, it's not paid. Oh, yes, that's paid. She went in the back and got the other lady. The other lady came out and looked over her shoulder. She said, not only that paid, but that one paid too. I'm standing there. Y'all think people just talking. I need somebody to know God about to get in the computer just for you. Oh, wait a minute. You ain't got to shout. And he only wants you to grab hold of some faith. Because I ain't got time to make you believe what I'm saying. Because God is not a respecter of person. He showed no partiality. None. I'm standing there and the lady telling me, that's paid. And that one is paid out. I sold a seat and the Cadillac that I had. And I knew I still had at least 3 more years to pay on that car. After I left Atlanta, Georgia one night, and Dr. Wanda Davis Turner sold the seed into me because I sold my last seed. But all the money I had in my pocket, I've been in the conference all week, ain't had no more money. And I prayed that no preacher wouldn't ask for another seed. I sure did. I said, Lord, please don't let nobody else come in and ask for no more money. Service was out almost over. Bishop Andrew Turner was getting ready to close out. And he said, you know, I hear the Lord saying that I need several people to sow a $200 seed. And that was the last seed I had. And I asked God, how I'm going to get my car to the airport? How I'm going to get my car? I got to get my car. How I'm going to do this here? And Lord, I went up and gave that seed and came back. And Wanda Davis Turner gave me a check. She said, Pastor Baker, she said, after she asked Mary Jackson, what is his first name? She told her. She said, Pastor Baker, the Lord told me, as quick as you give it, that's how fast it was coming back to you. And Monday, in my mailbox, was a letter and a title of a car that I knew I had at least 3 more years to pay for. The title, I went to the bank. I said, Miss Faye. She said, what's up, Mark? I said, you know the car that you allowed me to get? She said, yeah. I said, I got some more payments on that car. She said, I know, you're right, Mark. I said, but I got the title here. She got on the computer and looked. She said, Mark, it's saying it's paid in full. It's paid out. I said, but Miss Faith, me and you know, I still own this car. She said, but Mark, it's saying it's paid out. The Holy Ghost said, can you get up out of here and thank me for a blessing? Oh, I need 30 people right. Y'all don't want, I'm trying to help somebody. Really, I'm about to close because, see, I got this thing. I'm trying to give it to somebody. I'm serious. I got this. I got this thing. I'm trying to give it. I heard the Holy Ghost tell me, say, can you get up out of here and thank me for a blessing? And that same Cadillac, I gave it away. I'm here to tell somebody. If I have to speak it, because the blessing of God telling me to tell you that he's about to make you rich and add no sorrow. Somebody say, I don't believe that. Well, you don't believe the word. I'm about ready to close. Because you're trying to figure out how it's going to happen. You wasn't supposed to give no man no $2 million to get 21 acres of land and build a building like this and build another building. Who done filed every chapter in the book? You know why it don't bother with me when some people don't get with me? Because, see, they ain't never had bad credit. They always had everything going on. But I need some undignified people to know that if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I wouldn't even have the automobile. They would have kicked me. My mama had to help me get a ring. You got to say amen.
That's all right.
But when God.
When God.
When God. Helen, they still don't believe I worked in at the hospital in the dish room. Say that they still don't believe that I worked in the car wash at IAP. They still don't believe it. That lady told some people one time before, y'all better stop believing him. That boy ain't never worked in no hospital. I want to say I was born and raised here. There's some people who know me. You see the glory, but you don't know the story. I wish I had a witness up in here. I used to beat Dave so bad, he played for the Elks and I played for the JC. I knew he was going to talk loud then. They back there in the back trying to make me strike out. And I'm saying, your shoe down tied. I'm going to hit this ball, man. You got to have people in your life that know you. I need 30 people just shout out loud. God did it.
God did it.
Give him a praise for whatever he has done in your life. whatever he's about to do. Give him some praise in advance. God did it. Thank you, baby. He gonna do it too. He's not a man that he should lie. Neither he's a son of man that he got to repent. If he said it, he gonna do it. Write down what's in your mouth. Write it down. What's in your mouth? Kim, I heard him say that today. Tell him, what's in your mouth? What's in your mouth? Joshua 1 and 8. This book of the law should not depart. What's in your mouth? Because this book of the law should not depart out your mouth. But if you meditate day and night, God, I'm about to run in this place. And if you observe to do according, what's in your mouth? What are you saying? What are you saying? Throughout the whole pandemic, I was decreeing that I'm going to walk in divine health. I wasn't just quoting Psalm 91 because everybody was quoting it. 1,000 may fall at my side and 10,000 at my right hand. I had more scripture than that, just that one. He said he'll take sickness and diseases away from me. He gave me Proverbs 4. Now, son, give attention to my word. Verse number 4, incline your ears to my saying. Verse 20, put verse 20 there. Hallelujah. Woo, God says, it's working for me. Lord said, tell somebody right now, it's working for me. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ears to my saying. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Don't let them depart from your eyes. The reason why things are being prolonged and held up, because people are not putting the word. And they're trying to figure out, well, how we going to do this. How we going to do this. You know what it was like? March the 3rd, Sunday, 2020, for the last service to be in here. And we fixed to break ground on a building? You know the mind that I had to keep casting down? Every imagination and every high thing against the knowledge of God and bringing every thought into captivity? Everything that tried to come up against me. You are laughing stock. Y'all will not build. Good God Almighty. But because we kept holding to that word, y'all ain't got this. And we kept walking by faith. Let's shout. We weren't supposed to pay this building off in 14 years. I need 30 people to shout. We weren't supposed to pay these. Y'all ain't got to say amen. But I just heard God told me to tell you again, anything that God is in, it's got to grow. The Lord just told me to write this down. Tell somebody to write this down. Don't overload yourself. Not in this season. Don't overload yourself. Lord said, I want you to live. Oh, somebody give him praise. I want you to, God said, I want you to live. He told me to tell you, don't overload yourself. You know, I told you a couple months ago, the Lord told me, I do not have a lot of things. A lot of people think I might have a lot of things on my plate. I just have things needing attending to. Because I don't overload myself. And the Lord told me to tell you right now, anything he's in, it's got to grow. There's a pastor might be watching me tonight. I just gave him that word yesterday in North Carolina. If God is in it, it's got to grow. You don't even have to worry. The Lord told me to tell you, I don't want to feel like I'm shouting by myself, but the Lord told me to tell somebody right now, go on and shout, because he done took care of that, that dead. Oh, you don't want to shout? The Lord just told me to tell somebody, even if you're watching, he said, tell them, their action of praise going to make it happen. The action of God, I'm just so crazy to believe. He said, tell them, I've already taken care of that debt. And wait a minute, he just told me, he said, tell them, there will be a testimony not many days from now out of this church that God took care of debt. Somebody better shout, scream, whatever. See, I'm not going to have you worrying. I'm not going to have you worrying. Worrying? Worrying? I'm going to let you enjoy your life. I'm going to let you laugh, happy, be smiling. If I had to worry about every bill I got right now, my responsibility right now, I walk around mad every day. I will walk around mad every day. You would not want to be around me. People don't even know why I like to enjoy my life. Because I got so much other things that could steal my joy. But when I do what this old song said, when I turned it over to Jesus and I stopped worrying about it, I turned it over to the Lord and he worked it out. Do anybody can give God a praise? The old song say, turn it over to Jesus. He can work it out. That problem that I had, I just couldn't seem to solve. I cried and I cried. I kept getting deeper involved. But when I turned it over to Jesus and I stopped worrying about it, I turned it over to the Lord and he worked it out. Is there anybody in here who can say, I turned it over to the Lord and he worked it out? He told me to tell you, you worry about a bill. God say, I done took care of that one and some more. And he said, because the future is so big for you, I done took care of that too. Shout like you know he's already taking care. Matter of fact, say, this time next year, whatever bill you got, it's going to be canceled. That's a faith talk right there. That's an action talk right there. He gonna either cancel it. It's done. Touch somebody and tell them, say, my body is healed. Y'all done got that. I'm serious. Just go tell somebody. Say, I'm walking in divine health. Say, he came that I may have life and that I may have it more abundantly. Shout like you got the abundant life. Shout like you got the rich life. Go tell somebody and say, I'm walking in divine health. That's for somebody watching tonight. You might be in your bed, but I want you to confess it. I'm walking in divine health. Sickness and diseases can't come now. My dwelling place. Speak it. Speak it. Speak it. Speak it. Speak it like you know it. Decree it like you know it. You won't remember the last time you had a headache. You better speak it like you believe it. Your blood pressure gonna always be right. Come on, somebody, decree it, speak it, confess it. Grab your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, I ain't trying to be cute now. I'll act more undignified than this. I got too much in store for me. God got a plan for my life. God got some things he's setting up for me. I will not be where I'm at this time next year. If it's anything, I'm going to be increasing. I'm going to be multiplying. Shout out loud. Say, it won't end like this. Say, before 2023 get here, I'm going to go to confessing some things. Because I'm not taking no bills into 2023. All of my bills going to be paid in full. If not paid in full, they're going to be paid off. Move like you're moving. Some of y'all scared to move. Some of y'all scared to confess it. Open up your mouth and say, my action with my big mouth gonna make it happen. You ain't got to say amen. My action with my big mouth gonna make it happen. Oh, I might need to make a rap out of that. My action with my big mouth gonna make it happen. Believe that. Tell me to hush. Everything I got came from my big mouth. Everything I got. I was walking in a business one day and a man saw me. He said he saw me. He said when he saw me walking in there, he said, whatever he going in there for, he going to come out with it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
So he told another guy. He said, I saw Mark going in there. He said, I tell you what, whatever he going in there for, he going to come out of there with it. I tell people all the time, I've been used to hearing people tell me no. Because every no ain't final.
That's right.
I wish I had 30 people to give God a praise. I say every no ain't final. I told you one time, man, they kept turning me down. They said, you don't approve, you don't approve. Day after day, you didn't approve. I had a mindset that I was a day too early. I had a mindset you was the wrong person at the desk. Because I was decreeing and confessing what the word said. Genesis 26, when Isaac sold in a famine, the Bible said he reaped in the same year. And every time I sow a seed, I always put pressure on the word. And I go and I give Acts 10 and 34. That God shows no partiality. God do not respect. He do not. He respect principles. He have no respect for a person. He respect the principle that we live by. I told my son a moment ago, I can never hear forget Dr. Price telling me one day, it's lonely up here at the top. Dr. Price said, it's lonely up here. Just a few of us up here that want to walk by faith and not by sight. You'll never have to walk down with your head down. You'll never have to feel sorry for who you are as a child of God. The Bible says we being evil know how to give good gifts to our children. How much more will my heavenly Father give me if I ask him? I go to my daddy, my heavenly Father. And he take care of all of my needs. And as good as my father, and he's still here today, and as good as he is at 83 years old, good to me. You think about what my heavenly Father is to me. There's nothing that I couldn't ask my daddy for. To this day that he would not do anything in his power to make it happen. You imagine what my heavenly Father, if I asked him, he told me when my ways please him, he'll make even my enemies be at peace with me. He told me he'll prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemy. What does that mean? He'll set my future up right in their face. And what they say wouldn't be, God will make it happen. Because he said if I delight myself in him, he'll give me the desires of my heart. Oh, I need 30 people You talking about the seed of faith? You talking about the word of God. You talking about the word of God. You talking about meditating on the word. He told me to tell you again. I hope you got it. Those online, those in the house. What's in your mouth? What is coming out your mouth? What are you speaking? What are you decreeing? Do you wake up every morning with a mindset that every need is met over and above? Do you wake up with a mindset that this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it? Do you wake up with a mindset when you go into a city, and he said, I bless you in the city, and I bless you in the field. I bless you when you come in, and I bless you when you go out. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 28 and verse number 1. We're going home. Deuteronomy 28 and verse number 1. I love this. Now it shall come to pass. Yay! I love that. Yeah. It shall come to pass. If you diligently obey the voice of the Lord, your God, to observe carefully, listen, all of his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth. And listen what he said, verse 2. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you. Why? Because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city. Blessed shall you be in the city. Blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the fruit of your body. Don't make me shout. Somebody just throw their hand up real quick, man. Somebody might say, Pastor, I ain't been able to hold my hand up. The Lord told me to tell you, hold your hand up. Move your body, something that you ain't been able to do. Thank you. Blessed shall be the fruit of your body. Come on, Sonya. Let's believe we walking in divine health. Come on, Zanya. Let's decree it. Stop talking about what runs in your family. It stopped with you. I wish I had 20 people up here. Cast down those stuff. I watch people all the time just complaining about it. You can heal your own body with your mouth. Y'all ain't got to say amen. You can heal your own body with your mouth. You can heal your own body with your mouth. My mouth. Death and life again as well in the power of my tongue. And those who love it gonna eat the fruit thereof. I'm telling you, write this down. You know it though, but some that might don't know it. Everything that has, everything that is, and everything that will be a result of your own confession. And it's the truth. Yes. I don't know why the Lord told me to tell you again. What's in your mouth? Those that are watching, stop being happy about what God doing in other people's life. And shout about what he's doing in yours. Y'all don't got to say amen. I hear people tell me that all the time. They always talking about what this person doing and what that person doing. And it's okay to rejoice with others. But when can you say I got my testimony? That I know God is a way maker. Because if you shout about what you know God has done for you, can't nobody put water on your fire. Y'all ain't got to say amen. Nobody. Nobody can put water on your fire. Nobody. You know why I come to church? I told you this other day. I don't come to church because I'm the pastor. He saved me before I became a pastor. I just wanted to get out of that world. I was in it. And I thank God that he snatched me out of that world. Yeah! 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 I'm about to see another year in a couple more hours. Yeah. Y'all ain't got to say amen. It just hit me. It just hit me. What? I buried many friends. And I'm still here. I owe him some praise. I did the same thing some of them did. Oh, y'all can sit here and act like you owe God some praise. I dare somebody right now, you know some people have not even lived to see your age. And you are here today. And you were doing the same thing they was doing. You owe God a praise for extending your life. You owe God a praise. You owe God a praise. Tell your neighbors, I owe God a praise. I owe God a praise. This is it. The Lord told me to tell you, this is it. This is it. Make sure you keep this in your spirit. The blessing of God is tied to my obedience in his word. The blessing of God is tied to my obedience in his word. I'm walking in this thing. I want to walk in this thing. I want to walk in this thing. That's where the word of God is. It's tied. Write this down. And I need you to repeat this too, because it's very, very important. The word builds up my faith. The word builds up my faith. It does. I needed things to change in my life. I needed things to move. The word built up our faith. It built up our faith. It did. When we didn't even know how. It was the word. Holding fast to my profession or my confession. Holding fast to it. Hebrews 10:23. That's so important. The Lord just told me to tell you, the seed of the word, it stimulates. It causes you to grow. It causes you to grow. That's what that word does. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. The Lord just told me to tell you, as the scripture said, but just don't look at it because scripture said, he says, surely goodness and mercy are going to follow you. All the days of your life. I need somebody to get this in. We hear that, but the Lord told me to tell you right now. Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. It ain't going to be no sometime up, sometime down. There shall be a consistency. There shall be a flow in your life. Nothing will ever change from this day forth. If it's anything, increase shall be on your life. Nothing. Take no thought for tomorrow. He said, for tomorrow will take care of itself. Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of my life. Because I am a citizen of the kingdom of God. I'm a citizen of the kingdom of God. That's right. I live by the principles of the kingdom. I know there are laws in this land, but I'm a citizen of the kingdom of God. Oh, yes, I am. And he takes care of us. Matter of fact, he just told me to tell you, you really are an ambassador. You represent the kingdom of God. Lord, I wish I had some ambassadors in here tonight. I represent the kingdom. I represent the kingdom now. And then anyone that is a representation of a country, they are taken care of. And so when I represent God's kingdom, that means he done took care of every need for me. Some people got to get, if I'm an ambassador, I represent the kingdom of God. That's why I'm going to close on this, because a part of this is, it's got to be dealt with for 2023. Believers who ignore community problems do not represent the kingdom of God. And I don't know why, but he's going to really reveal more and more of that to me, why he want me. And he will not let that word get out of my spirit. He told me, he said, you will not ignore the community problems. Because if you go by as though certain things don't exist, you do not represent my kingdom. That's why I believe 2023, we're going to have so much prayer in this house. It's literally almost this whole house going to be nothing but men and women of nothing but prayer. Because he say, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and do what? Pray. And do what? Seek my face and turn from their wicked way. Then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins. And I will heal their land. This killing spirit got to get out of Brunswick. Y'all don't got to say amen. This murdering, gun token, slanging in this town, finding bodies on the streets, got to get out of this town. Because if we don't begin with our mouth and decree it, it's going to keep on happening. I had a mother just today pleaded with me. Her sons, she said, please pray. My house is getting shot up almost every night. Can I keep ignoring that? That's an issue. And the kingdom of God cannot ignore it. No longer. And we are equipped. And we got angels dispatched all around us. Come on, somebody. We will not be afraid of the terrors that fly by night, nor the arrows that fly by day. For he has given his angels charge over us to keep us in all of his ways. We will not, because that's somebody's son, that's somebody's boy, that's somebody's girl that are dying in our streets. And the church cannot ignore the community problems. And we're going to be what Isaiah said. We will be called the repairers of the breach. Come on, saints, for streets to restore us to dwell in. We cannot ignore what we see. We cannot just jump and shout. We got to meet the needs of another generation. We got to believe God. Oh, he said that everybody in this house is wealthy. Come on. Wait a minute. The Lord just told me to tell you, it's in your mouth. Don't be afraid to say it. I'm wealthy. Open up your mouth. Whatever the kingdom of God has need of, whatever we got to do, whatever the resources that it's going to take, education, whatever it's going to take, God, you will put me in a position to make it happen. Give God 30 seconds of praise, because we cannot rely on the system of this world. We can't. We cannot rely on the system of this world. Romans says it. The law is too weak. Romans 8, verse number 1. You wonder why, what's going on? The law is too weak. There is therefore now no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. Here we go. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh. The law is too weak. This thing is so high, it's principalities. to that, the law of the land is looking for the church. What can we do about what's going on? Oh, y'all ain't got to say amen. You're going to see the law going to have to come back to the spirituality of God is the God of this world, not Satan. Just because, come on somebody, he's the prince, he's the power of these heirs, but the earth is the Lord. And the fullness thereof. This earth don't belong to Satan. We can't let him think he can take rulership of it. We can't. So we're not going to do nothing. We're going to leave it to the law. And the law is too weak. It's too weak. It's too weak. We got to have programs. We got kids right now got to get out of the city of Brunswick because they're fear of their lives right now. Because guns is just rambling. If you could see a lady that's just today, he would tell you he was there. If you could have seen a lady today, she's about to just fall over herself. She's like, I got to get my boys out of here. Would you please pray for my son? My house being shot up. Now, not only my children is put in danger, but I'm put in danger. We. And it don't matter what neighborhood you're in either. So don't put it on the hood. Because he goes about walking about, seeking whom he may devour. Y'all ain't got to say amen. He on the island. He's everywhere. They're going through stores. They're not even afraid. Years ago, you'll go in the store and shoplift, and you don't care. You just do it when nobody don't see it. Now they going in there and they just ripping out everything. And the employees just standing back and saying, let them do what they got to do. What kind of land we're living in? And you gonna say, mother, you gonna say, father, you don't need to bring your children to church. You gonna have to bring them to church. You gonna have to. I challenge every mother. I challenge every father that's got a child. Keep them in the church so they can create a mindset of God. And don't worry, mother, just like me, even when I strayed away from the church, the seed was planted. Y'all ain't got to say, I need somebody to shout right now. Even Reagan, when I strayed away from the church, my mama and daddy had them planted the seed. And the seed of the word drew me back into the kingdom of God. Because I couldn't handle it. I couldn't deal with it. But thank God I had a way to get back to God. Thank God I had a way that I can, mama told me, say, I taught you how to pray. I taught you how to love God. I taught you all you got to do if you ever get yourself in a situation. Call on the name of Jesus. That name that is above every name. That at every knee got to bow. And every tongue got to confess. That Jesus is Lord of Lords. If you're watching, if you're here, and you're not saved, before this year go out, give your life to God. Can I say it again? Before this year is out, if you're in here and you're not saved, if you're watching online and you're not saved, give your life to God. The old saints will sing a song, just as I am, without a plea, O Lamb of God. Stand at your feet. Now, Lord, as we give our seeds or give our offerings or give our tithes, we honor you with our offerings. And even if no one have anything to give, God, I know they got a heart to give. And I pray, God, that every one of them, God, will always be able to say, God, I thank you for being involved in my finances. I know God. There will always be, somebody speak this, a continuous flow of finances in my life. A continuous flow of finances in my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Those that are watching online, if you're still online watching, I want you to give. I want you to sow tonight as well. Those that are watching all across this country, I want you to give. I want you to sow as well. You can see it on the screen. Let's trust God. Let's believe God.
Thank you for joining us here today at Greater Works Online. Stay tuned every week for our Wednesday Word Online at 7 p.m. and for our Sunday service at 9:30 a.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Don't forget to stay connected with us on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We pray these online services are a blessing to you and your families. If you have a prayer request, want more information about the ministry, or want to partner with us here at Greater Works, visit us at greaterworksfamily.com. We can't wait to hear from you. God bless you. Dios te bendiga.